In today's video, we're going to be talking about what is considered to be normal blood sugar and what that means for our health. Blood sugar, also known as blood glucose, is the amount of sugar circulating our blood at any given time. The body always tries to maintain homeostasis and keep blood sugar at a certain level. If blood sugar is too high, this can cause negative side effects, both short and long term. And the same goes for if blood sugar is too low. At the extremes of each spectrum, it can also result in death. And that is why the body has the capability to both lower and raise blood sugar as needed. However, poor metabolic health can impair our ability to regulate blood sugar, and this can result in blood sugar levels remaining elevated for long periods of time. When this happens, we are at a greater risk of heart disease, nerve damage, kidney damage, eye damage, and more. Knowing if your blood sugar is at a healthy level is important for overall health and disease prevention. There is also a strong correlation between your energy levels and your mood and your blood sugar levels. So in today's video, we're going to talk about what normal blood sugar levels are and why some people have slightly elevated blood sugar on a keto diet. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high-fat, nutrient-dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, where I share new posts every single day. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. For everything from websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform that does it all. Head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate to start your free trial today. We're going to start off today talking about what blood sugar is and its role in the body. Then we will get into what normal blood sugar levels are, and we'll finish off talking about why some people find that they have high fasting blood sugar on a keto diet. Blood sugar 101. As we already mentioned, blood sugar is the level of sugar in the blood at a given time. Blood sugar is important because it provides our bodies with energy. While most tissues in the body are able to run either completely or primarily on ketones or fat, there are some tissues that require a level of glucose, such as the brain and red blood cells. But where does blood sugar come from? One way we increase blood sugar is by eating foods rich in carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are broken down by the body into sugar, or more officially known as glucose, and they enter the bloodstream. And this is when your blood sugar rises. The excess sugar in your blood can either be used for energy immediately or stored for later. Your body stores some of this glucose in your muscle tissues and your liver, and the rest will be stored as fat. When you haven't eaten for a while and your body requires some glucose, some of this stored energy will be released back into the bloodstream and your blood sugar levels will rise. The body can also make glucose without you having to eat anything from non-carbohydrate precursors. This process is known as gluconeogenesis, and it will kick in anytime there is a need for glucose and none immediately available. And this is a totally normal process. If we didn't have the ability to do this, we would die. So your body creating glucose is nothing to be afraid of. When your blood sugar rises for any of these reasons, your body has mechanisms in place to bring it back down to baseline. So let's get into what that baseline is. Normal blood sugar. Now, in terms of how you can measure your blood sugar, you can always go into your doctor and do a blood test and measure it that way. But honestly, at home, blood glucose meters are inexpensive, they're super easy to use, and they are definitely worth the money. You can buy them at any pharmacy pretty much, or online from companies like Keto Mojo. And I will link to Keto Mojo in the description box down below if you want to check them out. But now let's get into what you should be looking for when you measure your blood sugar. Normal fasting blood sugar, so before you've eaten anything, is considered to be between 3.9 to 5.6 millimolars per liter, or 70 to 100 milligrams per deciliter. If your fasting blood sugar is higher than this, that may mean you have prediabetes, although there are some exceptions to this, which I will talk about later in the video. Levels of 5.6 to 6.9 millimolars per liter, or 100 to 125 milligrams per deciliter, and you will be considered to have prediabetes. And anything above 7 millimolars per liter or 126 milligrams per deciliter, and you will be considered diabetic. 1 to 2 hours after a meal, blood sugar under 7.8 milligrams per deciliter is considered to be normal, But I think we need a little bit more context here. Because for the average person who eats a lot of carbohydrates, bread, pasta, cereal, etc., this may be what they should aim to stay under. But for someone who is eating a low-carb diet, there's often next to no rise in blood sugar after a meal, because very little carbohydrates are being consumed. It should also be noted that measuring your blood sugar once, 1 to 2 hours after a meal, doesn't tell the full story. Your blood sugar could have spiked significantly higher before you measured and be coming back down, or it could be raising slowly and still continue to raise after you measure it. It's not worth stressing over these metrics constantly, but every once in a while, it can be good to check your blood sugar at 30-minute intervals for a few hours after eating to get a better sense of how the meal affected you and how your body was able to respond. Blood sugar on keto. And now I want to talk about some changes we see when we eat a low-carb ketogenic diet. As I previously mentioned, when we eat low amounts of carbohydrates, blood sugar after meals does not spike significantly. People who eat a low-carb diet often find their blood sugar is very stable throughout the day, and along with this, their energy levels and mood are also very stable. For those who are diabetic, pre-diabetic, or insulin resistant, they find that when they switch to a low-carb diet, their fasting blood sugar comes back within a healthy range very quickly. And this has been confirmed with numerous clinical trials. One peer-reviewed study tested the effectiveness of low-carb diets on type 2 diabetes, and they concluded the low-carb ketogenic diet improved glycemic control in patients with type 2 diabetes, such that diabetes medications were discontinued or reduced in most participants. Another peer-reviewed study concluded, while the current treatment for type 2 diabetes emphasizes drug treatment and a higher carbohydrate diet, the ketogenic diet is an effective alternative that relies less on medication. However, for some people who have been eating a ketogenic diet for a long period of time, their fasting blood sugar can become elevated slightly, either in the upper end of what is considered to be normal or in the lower end of what is considered to be pre-diabetes. And obviously, this causes concern for people, but there is a reason behind it, and that's what we're going to talk about now. What is happening here is known as adaptive glucose sparing. This is when someone has eaten a low-carb diet for an extended period of time and they have become fat-adapted. Most of the cells in the body have adapted to run on fatty acids and ketones, and therefore they have a much lower need for glucose. Now, as we spoke about earlier, there are some tissues in the body that require glucose, such as the brain. So tissues that do not require glucose, such as our muscles, refuse or spare it. And that way it can be used by the tissues that do require it. So what ends up happening is, well, when we eat a high-carb diet, there's lots of glucose available, and this glucose is mainly taken in by our muscles. But now our muscles do not need it, leading to slightly elevated circulating blood sugar levels. When someone who is fat-adapted wears a continuous glucose monitor, what we end up seeing is blood sugar levels highest in the morning and lowering slowly throughout the day, with no real increases after meals. The reason it is highest in the morning is due to something called the dawn phenomenon, which diabetics will be familiar with. The dawn phenomenon is when hormones such as human growth hormone and cortisol are released in the morning and cause the liver to release glucose into the bloodstream. This is basically your body trying to wake you up, and it happens just before you usually wake up in the morning. And again, this isn't a bad thing. It's just your body trying to do its job. So if blood sugar levels can be slightly elevated on a low-carb ketogenic diet, how can you know if you're pre-diabetic or not? I'm going to tell you how in just 1 second, but first I'm going to take a quick moment to tell you about today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is the absolute easiest way to design and run your website. Their all-in-one platform provides services for all of your needs, from email marketing and blogging to online stores and scheduling tools. With beautiful design templates and unlimited customization, it has never been easier to create a website exactly how you want it. No matter if you are looking for a website builder to run your business or for personal use, such as a landing page for an event, Squarespace does it all. Head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate to start your free trial without having to enter your credit card details or anything. And when you love it and decide to launch, use code HealthCoachKate to save 10% off your first order. Thank you again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Pre-diabetes and keto. Now, the thing about prediabetes is that it is the same thing as insulin resistance, and this often goes overlooked. I won't get too into insulin resistance today. I do have several other videos on the topic, which you guys can check out afterwards. But basically, measuring insulin in conjunction with glucose is a better way to determine how your body is handling blood sugar and if you are at risk of type 2 diabetes or not. The best way to measure this is through a HOMA IR test from your doctor. This puts your fasting glucose and insulin into a formula and gives you a number. Less than 1 is optimal, signaling you are not pre-diabetic or insulin resistant. Over 1.9 is pre-diabetic, and over 2.9 is diabetic. But unfortunately, a lot of doctors do not recognize the importance of testing insulin and will only run tests on glucose instead. So if your doctor is not willing to test your insulin or do a HOMA IR test, I do have another video with some at-home methods that you can try. Anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below what your fasting blood sugar is and if you saw any changes when you switched to a low-carb ketogenic diet. I am really curious to hear your results. And also remember to check out Squarespace for all of your website needs. I will put the link to their website in the description box down below. If you guys did enjoy this video, you might also like my video on how to test for insulin resistance at home. You can find that here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can click here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can click here. Thanks again, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.